If you like my dad's videos, please subscribe to QA Insights channel.
Hi, welcome back. In this lecture, we are going to deep dive into graphs in analysis. As you know, by default, you will get certain graphs based on the protocol you have executed. For Web HTTP HTML protocol, you will get these five graphs: running users, hits per second, throughput, transaction summary, average transaction response time. So by default, you will get a certain layouts for each graph. So by default, at the top, you can see the y coordinates and x coordinates and the respective parameters. And at the bottom, you can see the legend and also the graph data. So these graph data can be pulled, can be exported by going to the Windows menu and selecting the graph data. So here, if you click on this link, click to retrieve graph data, you can retrieve the appropriate graph data for your analysis purpose. So this can be exported to CSV or Excel sheet for your own analysis. And also you have the ability to configure the graph options by right clicking on the graph. So all the options are much similar to across all the graphs. For example, filter or group by, set granularity, view measurement trends, view cursor, and other options will be available across all the graphs. First, we will see how to set filter or group by in the graph. So just select the first option, set filter or group by, or you can use the shortcut key Ctrl plus T. So here you can set your condition. So by default for this graph, you will get these three conditions. One is the end status, elapsed time, and the view user status. So here you can customize your options and you can configure the duration here. And if you click on OK, the appropriate conditions will be applied to the graph and then it will display the right metrics. Next, we will see how to drill down to the graph. So drill down helps you to get to know about more details at a specific point of time. So now I have selected the hits per second graph and I am going to right click on the graph. So now you can see the drill down option is not available because there is no such metrics or data available to drill down. But if you go to other graphs, say running users, so here you can see drill down option is available. So I'm going to drill down. So now it will ask what parameter you want to drill down. So here by default, it is displaying the run option. So I'm going to group by end status and I'm going to click on OK. So now appropriate metrics will be displayed after drilling down. Now we will see how to drill down this one. So I'm going to drill down. So drill down to actions. So I'm going to select the group by as transactional hierarchical path. I'm going to click on OK. Now you can see it will displaying only the action underscore transaction details. So likewise, you can drill down. And if you want to undo the action, you can just press Ctrl Z. So it will come back to the old default view. So you can drill down or you can undo the drill down based on your needs. Now we will see how to set the granularity. So by default, for this graph, the granularity is 2 seconds. You can go with minimum of 1 second, but again, it depends on the data points available for the particular graph and also the type of the graph you are working. So here you can see, you can set to 1 second, which is minimum, or you can set to minutes or hours. So I'm going with 1 second and I'm going to select the option reduce for all graphs. So this operation can be long and take a lot of memory, so do not use this. So you can apply this granularity only to the specific graphs. So now click on OK. So now it is displaying the graph data based on the granularity set to 1 second. So similarly, you can view the measurement trends by using this option, view measurement trends. And one of the main option, important configuration I like is view cursor. So this option will display your cursor into like X mark, the plus pointer, where you can correlate the x and y coordinates. So right now, if I'm going to point this here, you can see the x coordinate, it is pointing to 5 seconds, and also the y coordinate is pointing to bytes per second, 220k bytes per second. So this option is pretty much useful, so please enable this view cursor option, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Control plus U. And one of the another option you will be needing is raw data. So many people will, what they do is they will export the raw data into an Excel sheet, and then they will do their own analysis instead of doing it in analysis. So to export the raw data, what you can do, you can just right click on the graph where you want to export and click on view raw data and select the range. So based on the graph you have selected, it will display the options. So here it is displaying the duration. So just click on OK and go to Windows menu and click on raw data. So here you can see the raw data has been populated here. So this can be exported or copy all rows. You can do it, or you can export to Excel sheet or CSV file. So like this, you can export your raw data in analysis. And another option is, we have already seen in the last lecture, merging graphs. So merging graphs will help you to merge between two graphs, and also you can merge with merged graphs. So you can do multiple graphs to be merged into one graph. And another important option I would like to share it with you guys is comments. So many people, what they do their analysis, but they don't add the appropriate notes to the analysis. So it is best practice you need to follow whenever you do some analysis. So what you can do is you can appropriate place location in the graph, right click and click on add comments. So here go to comments menu and click on add, and you can say first 5 minutes data, and just click on OK. So now you can save this, and whenever your teammates are opening the same file, they can also see the comments, and also it will be very helpful for you, so that no need to forget your analytic points, so that you can take appropriate notes in the graphs. So this can be edited. So that just right click on the comment and click on comments and edit. And here you can set the position size. You can change the callout option, pointer option, and format. And you can delete the comments as well. So just click on delete comment. It will automatically delete from the graph. Okay, now we will see another important option for the graph is display options. So by default, it is displaying the relative elapsed scenario time, I think relative time. So this can be changed by right clicking on the graph and selecting the display options. So display options in the time option section, you can change it to absolute time. And here you can display options, you can convert to 3D dimensional view, and also you can enable the legend in the graph, and options are available to change the color, and you can show the breaking measurement options, and advanced options will help you to customize the series, some general options, axis, panel, etc. So likewise, you can configure the display options as well by right clicking on the graph and selecting the display options. And if you want to see the properties of the graph, what you can do, you can right click and select in the properties. So in the properties pane, you can change this, we can view the properties, and also you can change the values for the appropriate options. So that's it guys from my side. So next video we will see about the autocorrelation in graphs. So I hope this video is pretty useful. Please let me know in the comments if you have any questions. If you have a time, please go to my next tutorial. Thanks for listening. Have a great day.
If you like my dad's videos, please subscribe to QA Insights channel.